Welcome back to the channel. This video is going to piggyback on yesterday's where we were looking at LUTs. I'm going to show you how to generate your own LUT off of a look that you've saved. So here we're back in looking at this shot where we ended up dialing in a look. And let's say we like that. Once you have your shot dialed in, so everything's set how you like it, go to the clip down here. It's a little counterintuitive. You would think you could grab a still. And you can export it with a display LUT on it, but to actually just export a LUT, you're going to go down to your clip here and right click, and there's a little generate LUT. And you have a few different options, how many points there are. So let's go with the 33 point cube. It's going to name it that. It automatically goes to your LUT folder. And let's just call this SLOG709. And we'll call it custom. So now we have a new LUT right there. Let's go ahead and right click and say reveal in Finder. SLOG custom, it actually gave it the entire clip name, which is a little funky. Let's go ahead and rename it. We'll just call it custom batname.cube. Let's go over here and we'll hit refresh. And now we have the SLOG custom 2. So that means we could actually reset this node here. Drop it down from the LUT list and go all the way down to the bottom, SLOG 709 custom. There's our look. And now that that's dialed up, everything is not going to be changed as far as our tools go down here, our graphs and all of our settings, but it's baked into that LUT. So if you wanted to start out with this look right here, you can start right there and do that even from the media pool. So if you're over here in your media pool, let's delete this LUT again here and we'll say no LUT. So now we're back to that flat look and we go back to our footage here and we find this shot in the Finder, which is right here. We can right click it, choose our LUT before we even add it to our timeline and come down to our 709 custom. Now it's good to go. So if we added this shot down here, let's go ahead and bring it in. Now with the LUT on, it looks good right off the bat. That's it, adding a LUT and saving it. And you can apply it to all your clips. So if you got some iPhone footage or a GoPro or something, and you dial in a look that you like, save your own custom LUT and then just add it to your media pool to all the clips. And then you're kind of good to go right off the bat and you don't have to do a bunch of manipulation. All right, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. As always, leave a comment if you got a suggestion you want me to make a video on. And thank you for subscribing if you have. If not, please do, because it really helps me out and I appreciate it. Talk to you guys on the next video.